In my book Schematics 1, I've published a circuit from a variable sine wave oscillator. And here the circuit is showed. It looks quite complicated, but it is not at all. We have here a phase shifting network consisting of capacitors here, a few of them, and resistors. And in fact, it's the same circuit in its principle compared to this circuit. Though there are some adaptations, again, in fact, the same circuit as it's showed here and showed here in that book. A phase shifting network, a backup coupling capacitor, and a transistor that amplifies. And with a sine wave oscillator, we have always a problem that it has to generate a very pure sine wave. That means that the amplification must be limited to 1. And that's a whole issue. Anyway, go back to the circuit that I've showed earlier in this video here. The sine wave oscillator. And you can see here 3, 1, 2, 3, 4 switches. That means that you need a DAC switch, with which you can set and variate the backcoupling capacitor here, and also the 3 capacitors in the phase shifting network that set the frequency band. And this is only a limited, this gives only a limited frequency band. And here are the frequencies that you can reach with the schematic that I show here. 160 Hz up to 580 Hz, 3.3 kHz to 4.2 kHz, and 14 kHz up to 16 kHz. That has all to do with the typical properties from a sine wave oscillator in this figuration. A sine wave circuit that can have a broader frequency band is called a so-called Wien oscillator. And this is not a Wien oscillator, but a very simple 1 or 2 transistor sine wave oscillator. So when you want to go to more frequencies, you need a switch with 1, 2, 3, 4 DACs that can switch much more capacitors here in the phase shifting network. And say between 150 Hz and approximately 20 kHz. And in that case, you get a quite good fine tuning by using this circuit with the potentiometer here from 100K. This potentiometer aligns the output frequency somewhat, not too much, and that has all to do with the properties from the sine wave oscillator, with its typical amplification factor from 1. But anyway, this is a quite good circuit, and I pan over somewhat. Here you see the whole circuit works very good, and also can be aligned to certain frequency bands, etc.